I think it's fairly safe to say that in more recent times, Ashmead has become one of England's most iconic carp waters. Not only does it contain some really special carp and some big carp as well, I think the late record's about 58 pounds, it also is so unique with all of the little bays, the little islands. I've never seen a carp water like it, and I've fished an awful lot of venues all around the world and I've never seen anything like this place. It's really, really unique. It's very special as well. It's a long way from the commercial world of carp fishing that you see on lots of venues around the UK, because you come to somewhere like this, it's almost like going back in time. But years ago when I started carp fishing, it's a little bit like that, because all the swims are left untouched and you can be so far away from another angler, you're not aware that there's anybody else on here. So that's why I keep coming back here, and it's why lots of other anglers keep coming back here, because it gives you something different, something where it's you against the fish, and that every time you do catch a fish, it feels really rewarding as well. Whenever you fish on Ashmead, you have to do a draw for swims, and there's a maximum of 8 anglers allowed on the lake at any one time. So it's always a little bit of an exciting time doing the draw, but I ended up coming out 5th, so I didn't get my first choice of swim, but I did still get an half decent area. I ended up in a swim at the back of Gallops, one of the little channels where there had been quite a few fish out of there over the last couple of weeks. So I was pretty confident because I had seen carp in that area as well, but it was a bit of a tight swim in that you just got like a channel moving out to the left and a channel to the right. So there wasn't a great deal of scope for me to move my rods around, but I ended up getting really lucky because on my first night I caught a fish, well, the second morning I should say, after the first night, I caught a fish quite quickly. So just getting my first fish from Ashmead, especially when you drive so far from Yorkshire down to here, is always the goal. And I started things off with a 22 pound common, so we'll take a look at that fish now. Oi oi, first morning and got one already, so yeah, proper chuffed. By the looks of it, it's a 20 plus common, so doesn't matter how big they are in this place though, it's always nice to get one. So Ashmead looking absolutely beautiful as always. Awesome. Let's take a look at it. First morning and first carp, 22 pound common, so absolutely made up, because just being at Ashmead is what it's all about, and catching a carp, trust me, it's a bonus, it really is. Lovely.
The nature of Ashmead, with all these little bays and channels and stuff, would make you think that maybe the fish would spook out of an area quite quickly, but sometimes they do pass through there regularly. And the area that I was fishing those channels, the next day I started to see one or two carp still in there, so I decided to stay put and managed to catch myself another carp on the second day, and that was a 24 pound common, which came about 1:30 in the morning. And even then there was still carp in the swim, which I was quite surprised about. But the next day I managed to catch probably my milestone fish from here, because I always want to try and catch a certain size of fish when I go to a new venue. And with this being my second trip and my first trip not producing a 30 pounder, I thought, right, I'd love to get a 30 pounder from Ashmead. And on the third day at 10:30 in the evening, I managed to catch a 31 pound common, which I was really chuffed with. Now that fish, it really did fight hard. It put up a good scrap and there was a lot of commotion in the swim. Lots of lights going off because of me doing a bit of video footage of it and stuff. And with Ashmead being quite a quiet venue, I did think that maybe those carp had moved out of that area the next day, because what I noticed was that the water had gone from being a little bit of a murky colour into a more of a clearer, gin clear type of colour to it. So at the back of my mind, I was thinking about maybe moving swim. And what happens on Ashmead is after 3 days, some of the guys tend to leave, because you can book either for 3 days or for 6 days. And I knew that the guys that had been in North and South Goat had been catching quite a few fish. Old Bill Phillips had been on the lake. He'd had a 35 pound common and a 30 pounder from South Goat. But his mate James in North Goat had also had a 35 pound common and a 28. And with North Goat being my favourite swim on the lake, and if I'd come first in the draw, I'd definitely have chosen that swim, I decided to leave the area of the back channels and go into North Goat. And there are a few reasons for that. I know it might sound a bit bizarre moving out of a swim that's doing your bites regularly, but as I say, the nature of Ashmead is that if you do make a little bit of a noise, chances are the fish are going to move out of there. And with that colour of the water changing slightly, I thought that was definitely the case. And with North Goat becoming available, it's a huge piece of water, North Goat is. There's loads of options. There's a chance to spread the rods around, and there's always carp passing through that area as well. It's kind of the heart, the central heart of this lake. And in that there's so many different arms and channels that lead off around into all the bays and other areas of the water. And also you've got the opportunity of fishing not just in North Goat itself, but you've actually got the chance of putting some rods over the back into the channels, into the square bay, where I know that one or two of the bigger fish have been caught in the past as well. So that's basically where we are now. I'm sat here in North Goat. I've not had anything from this swim yet, but I am definitely confident because there's loads of opportunities and loads of chances to row the rods around in this area if nothing happens. As the light fades on another autumnal evening at Ashmead, there is a sense of optimism in the air. The conditions feel right for those bigger fish to start making an appearance, and I'm convinced that someone around the lake is in for a surprise tonight. Fingers crossed, the move into North Goat pays off for me, and I'm not left with my tail between my legs come the morning. Quiet, apart from the farmer. But I'm not complaining because the old boy's been doing his harvesting, which is hard work at this time of the year. So you wouldn't notice it if it was an area that was quite noisy, but this place is so quiet, you do hear the farmer. But yeah, all quiet on the rods, unfortunately. So lots of things going through my mind at the moment because I've moved out of a swim that I'd done three nights in, had three fish. And then I moved into here and not had anything. So yes, this is what happens when you fish somewhere like Ashmead, because there's so many back channels and so many areas where the fish migrate through and hide away that you're always sort of thinking in your mind, you know, you've got to stay on top of the fish. You've got to stay in tune with the fish as well. And, you know, it's, yeah, good thing about having a dog though is I'll definitely be doing some laps this morning and seeing if I can find the fish. But you know, this swim, the good thing about it is this is called North Goat. The good thing about this area is it's almost like the central part of the lake, really, the heart of the lake, because you've got all the channels leading into this area. And the few days I've been down here, it's done some big fish as well. There was a lad in here called James who had a 35 and a 28. And then South Goat, which is literally just behind this island, Bill Phillips, good old legend of carp fishing, been around a long time, Bill, and Ashmead regular as well. He also had a 35 and I think he had a 31 as well. So that's the reason why I came in here, because it's been doing big fish. And you just know with this time of the year that any moment soon somebody's going to get a big one. You know, that's why we're all down here, all the lads that are down here, they're all booked on for the 6 days, and they're all in knowing that there's big fish getting caught. I don't know how many fish have been out whilst I've been here, but it's something like about 7 or 8 fish, and a large proportion of those have been over 30 pound as well. So yeah, something's going to happen sooner or later. It's just a case of when and where, because you know, you've got to find them, you've got to track them down. So as soon as I've had my breakfast in a minute, probably after about 10 o'clock ish, something like that, I know the dog will be wanting a walk, so I'll be doing the rounds, and whether I stay here or not is going to be decided by that. So yeah, decisions. Dunk away. Dunkin' Donuts. Can't beat them. Digestive in a coffee.
Just having a walk round and seeing if we can see any fish. There's always a few knocking around in these little back channels. It always seems to be early afternoon when they start appearing. Sure, at other times of the year you probably see them all day, but certainly during this trip it's always been early afternoon, just as it starts to get a little bit warmer. So that's one of the good things about having a dog, is they've got a walker. This is the area where I started off from. Did three nights in here and had three fish as well, so to move out of there and to go into a new swim, yeah, a bit of a risk, so hope it pays off. Oh, it's just boshed. I was walking around, you can just see the rings going out there, something down here, and then the coots let out a toot toot like they do. Something's in this area.
Yeah, there's a few fish over the back there, mate, and that little pond there, I think they call it the square pond. There's a few over there, group of about six fish, and yeah, pretty decent fish as well. So when I redo my rods in a minute, I think I'm definitely going to stick one over the back there. It's got to be worth a shout. Right, I need to be pretty stealthy now. So hopefully the dog will stay behind. Why is that like that? Right, let's go and drop this in. Got carp right over the spot now. He's deciding when to put the bait out, because in water like this you can easily spook him out of the area if I make too much disturbance. That'll do. That'll definitely do. That's the blue rod. Don't let me forget. In the middle of the night, when you've been asleep for a few hours, you get that blaring take. You've got rods spread all over the place. That's what happens at Ashmead. You've got one to the right, one in front of you, one down to the left. You've no idea which rod is going. So if the blue light goes, it's the one to the right. They've not been like this since I've been here in this bay. The very fact that they're here, they're going to be catchable. But you sit there thinking, Wish I'd got the rods in before they arrived. But I ain't spooked them anyway. If that rod's out, that's all right. It's whether to put another one in here or not. Those two rods moved into a new area, I was left with a sense of optimism following the disappointment of a blank night. And to my surprise, I didn't even have to wait long, as one of the rods I'd repositioned in the back channel let out a series of bleeps and we were into an Ashmead carp. I think you can tell there's loads of weed in this swim, so you need proper tough gear fishing in these kind of conditions. And at the moment, the old 15 pound outline, he's doing a sterling job for us. I think he's nearly there. Oh, the big load of weed. Let's get the weed as well, just to be sure. Yep, another one. Bit of a battle with the weed, but another Ashmead carp. Lovely, lovely times. That didn't take long. Rod's only been out about an hour and I've got myself a nice low 20 common, but I'm keeping my voice down because there's still fish in the swim. Even though this is only a little area that I'm fishing, there's been backs cruising along just over the back there. So I'm just gonna get this one out as quickly as I can and get that rod back out there, because I think there's definitely a chance of another fish. And from what I can see, there's certainly a few bigger fish amongst those that's been cruising around as well. So fingers crossed. Anyway, let's have a look at this one. We've just weighed it and it's weighed in at 26 pounds, so lovely. Absolutely beautiful fish. Now, when I put this one back, I'm not going to put it back in the square pond. I'm going to put it back this side of the lake, just so it doesn't linger in that area, because there's definitely a good chance of another bite or two from that area. There we go. If he wants to get back round to that area, it's got a bit of a swim. Key to success on a lake like this ain't necessarily your baits and your rigs, it's definitely your stealth. And at the moment, we've got fish in the swim. I've just landed one and I've still got carp here. So the last thing I want to do is start thrashing that water to a foam and telling them that I'm here. So I've just got to be very careful about when I redo this rod. There's a group of fish in here. There's only about half a dozen of them. And over there to the right, there is roughly about that sort of figure. So I think I'll be all right to just drop this rod in. And all I'm doing is just fishing to that little hole in the weed. And I'm just going to do it as stealthily and carefully as I can. Oh, that's perfect. It's gone down lovely. Oh, that's all done. So I just need to get out of the swim now and leave the carp to it. With the rod back in position, it was time to sit back and take it all in. However, the evening's action wasn't over just yet, as what happened next was a moment of pure Ashmead magic. Right, one of these rods behind the bivvy has just gone. It's not been out very long either. That looks a nice common. I just need to get the net underneath it, mate. With tips stuck in the tree and all the line of the tree. Come on, that's a big fish. It looks like a big fish. Yes, yes, oh mate, I've got it. What result that is. What a fish that is. Oh God, that's got to be an upper 30. Absolutely made up with that one. Brilliant stuff. the magic of Ashmead. I am proper buzzing with that one, so let's take a look at it on the bank. Fantastic. I only just moved that rod as well, so what a result. Oh, that's a good fish, that is. That is a good fish, mate. Don't wait, Bobo. Go out the way. That's a big old fish, that is. That's a lovely old carp. Right, let's get the rig out. Proper magical moment, because that is one of Ashmead's gems. An ounce is short of 40 pounds. That is a proper result. Second visit to Ashmead. Came here last year and had a really great time. And if I'm honest, I just knew that this time of year, everything was right for a biggin. And it's felt really good ever since I got here. And there you go, £39, 15 ounces of Ashmead common. Absolutely wonderful. Wow, what a fish. One last look at her. That is absolutely beautiful. What a memory to catch from this fantastic lake. Thank you so much, Ashmead. Thank you to the Carp Society as well. I am proper made up with that, I really am. Almost speechless. I love Ashmead, it's a beautiful venue. So to catch a carp like that is the stuff of dreams. Fantastic stuff. What about that, Bobo? You like that, did you? Eh? Now I've got to get out of this thing. That ain't gonna be easy. Hey, how's that, baby? What a fish.